Also in 2006, Ruben Abati, who then went on to become the presidential spokesperson, sat down with a group of young aspiring journalists to advise them on how to keep integrity, whatever you do, in 2006. I think you should see it. I enjoyed watching it.
All of us cannot be in politics. You know, but the danger is that persons who are in politics, when they listen to those who are contributing to public debate, they condemn them. They say, oh, if he thinks he's so good, why doesn't he come here to come and do what we two are doing? But the problem is that all of us cannot be there. And when you question people who are making a contribution, who are expressing the opinions, you know, you are trying to close up the space. And one of the things, you know, I've always said is that for us to have a proper democracy, we must continue to expand the space for debate, because society, you know, can only develop to the extent of the quality of thought that you find in that environment. What Huxley calls, you know, the current of thought in society. And, you know, our task is to continue to contribute to ideas. And people like me who write, who comment, you know, what we're just doing is to build ideas and criticize the system. Because if you look at the Nigerian system, it's not structured for efficiency. It's not structured for progress. It's the institutions are problematic. And that is why even when good persons go into that system, because I believe that there are some good persons within the Nigerian system, the Nigerian system, you know, compromises them. And we must have a way, you know, of creating a leadership structure whereby, you know, individuals who want to serve, who have faith in the common good, can function properly within the Nigerian environment. And that is why persons who are calling for a debate in form of a national conference, in form of a reconsideration of the Nigerian question, are making a valid point. And such persons ought not to be discouraged, because the basic question we first have to resolve is about nationhood. Are we a nation? You know, where do we stand? All those issues about power relations, about federalism, these are important issues.
But I have 3-4 questions for you and short answers. Number one, do you make money doing what you do?
Money? What kind of question is that? I don't know. I don't know what you mean.
Do you make a living? People always wonder, as a columnist, how do people make money? They don't understand the dynamics of your work.
No. The simple thing is that, you know, apart from all these iron things about ideas, about debate, I'm an employee. I'm a worker. I'm a laborer. I work in a company. I'm part of a business. I'm a member of a team. And I get paid. I get remunerated for what I do, you know, and I'm okay. I'm comfortable. I mean, when you say money, you make it seem as if...
I know this suit isn't cheap, so I mean,
The thing is that in journalism, people who are looking for money, you know, who want to ride Homer Jeep, don't let them bother about coming into journalism, you know, because it's not a money-making business. It's like a missionary task. It's for people who want to engage society. It's for people who want to make a contribution.
Right.
You gain a lot of influence, you know, you become important, you become relevant, you know, you derive a lot of satisfaction from what you do. But, you know, young people these days, when, you know, you see a young person, you say, oh, I also want to ride a Hummer Jeep. No, you know, it takes time. And the more time you spend in journalism, the more you grow and the more opportunities that you have.
Do you smoke?
Really, I don't think anybody should write for money. What?
Do you smoke?
No, I don't smoke.
Do you drink?
Social drinking, yes.
How many women are you married to?
What kind of question is that?
Well, we're building a future where we'll be able to ask our leaders this kind of question, because it will affect, you know, holding sensitive political offices in the future.
Okay, I'm married to only one woman. One man, one wife.
Do you
service enough?
Do you service Richard cards?
What's that?
Do you people understand? It's a new Nigerian term, isn't it?
No, recharge cards.
Recharge cards. You say
I have a GSM phone and I buy recharge cards to keep it going.
But you don't service other recharge cards.
No, I don't service other recharge cards. I know where you are going.